Yolu kalmış kaldı.
Döneceğiz.
Welcome to Sean Finn Park, Red Keel, on the 29th of September 2007 for the West Junior B football final between Newcastle West in the black and white and Kilcarnan in the red and white. Paddy Vaughan from Kilcarnan going on a solo run. Ball out to Derek Burke. Derek gets a second chance at it. Kenneth O'Donoghue has the ball back to Paddy Vaughan. Has a chance at a point. That's a fine score for Kilcarnan. There's no nerves there. That's a good start where he belongs. So another kick out now from Willie Kavanagh. It's a high ball to be contested. Paul McGilligan has it. Paul should have a look. He's Derek Burke. Net foot from Derek, looks like it's going short. No, that's a fine score. That's 2 points to no score for Kilcarnan, and a right good start from the team in the red and white. James Hennessy, the Newcastle West centre back, he's the ball in his hand. He's a look up. It's a poor one. Paddy Vaughan has intercepted it. Paddy's trying maybe to knock a bit too much out of it. Well done, Paddy. He's through now. It looks like a ball that's going to be intercepted there by Michal O'Keefe. Joey McGilligan has it. Joey has a chance. Has a quick look at the score. And that's gone over the bar. And that's 3 points to no score for Kilcarnan. That's a fine score from Joey McGilligan. Paddy Vaughan, a footballer and hurler of note, playing very well in this game. There's Derek Burke has possession. Derek has a look, lines it up. It's a great attempt at the score, but it's not going to make it all the way. It's gone over. Bit of a surprise here in the Newcastle West camp that their goalie didn't come out and claim that one. I don't know whether Rory Maher got an assist in it or whether it went straight over from Derek Burke's kick. But that makes it 4 points to no score from Kilcarnan, and you'd have to say it's still very much one-way traffic at this stage. Ian takes the freeze for the Kilcarnan hurling team as well, indeed captain of the hurling team this year. Takes the ball from the hand, Derek Burke calls for it. Always showing, Paul McGilligan. It's a fine kick by Paul McGilligan, it's a fine point, but a point you'd have to say made by Derek Burke, captain of the football team in Kilcarnan last year when they were beaten by Knockadara in a replay of the West Final. Unfortunate actually not to win it the first day. And Knockadara went on to win the county and indeed represent Limerick in the Munster football final. This ball being kicked in, is it by Shane Whelan? Hugh Sheehy going running for that one. Brian Kenny has the ball. Cregan is goal side. Kenny takes him on. Brian still has the ball. Drops it. Ray Nash puts in a boot. Ray complaining to the referee. Don't think he'd get away with that one though. Sean, I think, was he in this year's county minor team?
He was.
Sean, a county minor this year. Nice attempt at a free. One would wonder why he didn't take the last few frees for Newcastle. So that's it, 5 points to one. Now Tony Doyle has it. Tony, captain from Newcastle West. It appeared to be taking on too much in that one. Wins the free. Looked to have walked the free, really. Giving the ball to Noel Hennessy. Noel Murphy. Noel gives the ball out again as far as Sean McAuliffe. Sean and Hugh Sheehy. Hugh on his back, I'd say. Sean has it. Carl Fulham has a chance, has a look. That looks like 5 points to two, and there might be a small bit of a comeback on here. Newcastle West have started the second half much better than they were playing in the first half. Armin Ian has it. Danny Ivis is calling for it. Gives the ball to Danny. Danny has a look. Puts boot to ball. And who again but Paddy Vaughan. Man of the match as far as I'm concerned so far. Paddy breaks through. Give the ball through to Rory. Joey McGilligan. Joey has a look. Kicks it over the bar. That's a fine score. Well worked. Came through from Danny Ivis up as far as Paddy Vaughan, who went in a great run. And Joey, I think for his second score of the game, collected and did easy with, I suppose, Joey. Noel Mulcairn too happy about it. Ball through now to Kevin O'Keefe from Paul McGilligan. Back again to Rory Maher. Another belt from the fullback. That fullback, I think, thinks he's involved in the WWF at this stage. Rory's not too happy with that either. Rory do well to keep his counsel now. He's 4 points up in the West Final. Billy Phillips having a word with Pat Lee. So 6 points to two in favour of Kilcarnan as Denny has a go at this one. Looks much better. There you go, the sixth one's a charm for Denny Ivers. That's 7 points to two in favour of Kilcarnan. Noel Murphy wins that ball. Comes back out to Michael O'Keefe, again playing a fine game this time. Noel Murphy has it, gives it back to Michael O'Keefe. Derek Burke wants to hold hands, but Michael is having none of that. Keane Maloney tries to fly hack that one. Here comes the second half. Substitute Shane Whelan gives a great ball down towards Tony Ahern. Tony now has a look, kicks the ball across. This is coming to Dahi Nash. Dahi doesn't seem to know what to do with it. No prisoners there from Kenneth O'Donoghue, but Keith Power has it. Fouled by Keane Maloney. It's another chance for Newcastle West to eat into the lead.
Ready, Pat.
And Sean McAuliffe again is kicking this one. Newcastle West are bringing on another substitute. They're bringing on Parkeen. As Shane McAuliffe lines this one up, Parkeen is warming up for Newcastle West. Sean, of course, has won from one from frees already. He's played a fine first half, and that's a fine free as well. County Minor this year. 7-3 in favour of Kilcarnan. Jerry Martin has the ball yet again. Tony Hearn calling for it, all in his own. Shane Whelan did well there. He had no right to win that ball. Looked like Keane Maloney was going to get it. Now Keith Power has it. Tries a toe-to-hand. Doesn't work. Gets in the way with Tony Hearn. Tony has it. Gives the ball through to Keith Power again. Keith picks that one up quite nicely. Runs across the pond. It's not called the ball garden for nothing. Looks like he's tried to manufacture a free, and it would appear Billy Phillips has given it to him. At this free, as I said, to try to point his third from four attempts. A fine free taker. You'd wonder why he wasn't taking the frees in the first half for Newcastle when two or three went aimlessly wide. That's another fine attempt from Sean. A fine footballer. A man we might see maybe wearing the green of Limerick at the senior level in a few years to come. But at the moment, he's a job in his hands. It's 7-4 down with something like 15 minutes to go in a West final. Being challenged hard, but seems to have escaped. Conan Boys are more interested in shouting at the ref. Keith Power has the ball. Kicks the ball across to the corner. That's a new sub. I don't know who he is. Has a goal. That's a fine score. They're calling him. What's his name? Ken. Remember the score there.
What's his name, lads? What's his name?
Oh, Parkeen. Pair the second half sub. That's a fine score. It's 7-5. Now a sideline ball well caught by Anthony Cregan and cleared out, taken from him by Mike Kelly. Sean McAuliffe again has it. Sean looking for room. Gives it into Noel Whelan. Noel has a kick. Noel Murphy. That's a fine kick. That's Noel's first contribution from play, but a fine point. 7-6. Now with 4 or 5 minutes to go. Jerry didn't really know what he was doing with it there. Blaine Collins tried to contest, but Jerry still has it. Gives the ball down the line as far as Parkeen, the man that scored a fine point a few minutes ago. Pair takes on Anthony Cregan and wins that one. Ball comes through to Sean McAuliffe. Oh, a fantastic save from Paddy Ivas. Number 4 from 6 attempts. This would tie the game up at 7 points apiece, which is surprising in light of how poor Newcastle West were in the first half. Now Mike Martin has the ball, gives the ball in as far as Sean McAuliffe. Sean tees it up, that's a fine score. That makes it 7 points apiece. Now Tom's trying to find some room, gives it to Paddy Vaughan. Is Paddy Vaughan about to make a name for himself? That's a 45. I'm sure Danny Ivas is going to have to stand up to this one. Has a look at the posts. It's a fine kick from Danny Ivas, it's tailing off a bit. No, it's a fine score. That could be a score to win a West final. From a fine footballer, Danny Ivas. I think they'll probably forgive the 5 or 6 he's missed if that one's good enough for the season. Ronan Hanley is trying to be a timekeeper. The match is blown up. Kilcarnan have won their first West football title for a good number of years, and I would have to say a deserved champion. It's a fine performance.
Ladies and gentlemen, on behalf of the West Senior Board, it gives me great pleasure to congratulate both teams for an excellent final played here this evening. It went down to the wire, it was anyone's game. I suppose you could say it was a game of two halves, but in the end, Kilcarnan held out. And I think no one begrudges Kilcarnan. It's a long time since they won this championship, I think since 1974. So wish them the 94, sorry. We wish them the very best of luck, and congratulations and well done.
Well done, boys.
But thank our referee Billy Phillips and his umpires. I think they're doing an excellent job. And also to Red Keel Club for the use of the field here this evening. This final was to be played in Newcastle West, but it had to be switched here for Newcastle West to give fair play to everybody. And I know that Newcastle West don't begrudge Kilconnor this win. Newcastle have won it in a few occasions, and maybe these teams might meet again before the year is out. So I wish both teams every success. And now I will call in the captain of the Kilconnor, Ronan Handy, is it?
So two of us think. My lads! My lads!
So that's the Kilcarnan team, West Junior B football champions 2007. Well done, the lads.